This
Start.
conference will now be recorded.
Let me share. So right now I logged in as a developer one. So in case if you want to see the work objects which you created earlier and which you did not resolve it. Okay, so still they are further processing. Okay, I stopped in the middle of the work object processing. Or if somebody has been routed the work objects to you. So if you want to see them, then you can see it from your work list. So as I am the developer, and if I want to see my work list, so generally the way is go to the designer studio, case management, and then again tools, my work, and again my work list. So here I'm not attending this from John. Second, can you please provide the videos? Yeah, may I know who is that? May I know your name? Your name? Sorry,
Narendra.
Oh, Narendra. Okay, John second. Oh, almost 2 weeks it's over, but out of 2 weeks, okay, I think from last Friday we were not having the classes. Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday were not there. So only it started again from yesterday. So you might have missed around 6 to 7 classes. Yeah, we will share. I think already they are keeping in the shared drive, right?
No, sir.
Oh, no. Yeah, I will make it update immediately. So, okay. Narendra. Okay. You change your name now. Okay. Narendra, you just change your name from Pega to Narendra. Your name shows as a Pega. Okay. Yeah. So, here this is the work list. So in this work list, you can see all the work objects which are created by you, or else if somebody has routed it to you for work object processing. So when we will be routing it generally, for example, as I said yesterday, maybe you did not join that. Okay, so first of all, end user is going to create the application for insurance. Okay, so if the insurance amount which you are applying is around 10 lakhs or 20 lakhs, likewise, we can set some limit. Okay, so I'm taking the insurance for 20 lakhs, then that is fine. I can give the approval. So based on checking your salary details and all these things, okay, so 20 lakhs would be fine. If the package is around 50,000 to 60,000, okay, then I can issue the policy for 20 lakhs. But in case if you ask the policy for 1 crore or 10 crore, something like that, okay, then what we should do? Okay, I need the manager approval. Okay, this is the exceptional scenario. In that case, once after creating the case for you, I will be routing it to the manager approval. So the manager will be doing the more verification on the candidate. So his previous tracking history, how he paid the loans, how he paid the amounts, and if he claimed any insurances, how he is claiming the insurances. So they are the valid one, they are the genuine, otherwise he's simply keeping something bad, and again his track record is bad, then I can reject it. So these kind of the verifications for performing, what I will do is I will be routing it to the different operator. So that different operator is like a manager. So from the manager, okay, the manager will be further processing the work object. If he feels that, okay, he is good, he is the good person, okay, he can take the, we can issue the policy, then again he can approve it, and again he can send it back to the user one. Okay, so like that. So once if you route any work object for the manager, manager can go to his work basket and he can see, he can go to his work list and he can see the work object which are assigned to him. So likewise, any operator, if you want to see the work object which are assigned to him, okay, so as this is a developer portal, I have shown you like this, we can go to the work list like this. Okay, here we can see all the work objects which are under his work list. So H227, all these things. In case if you want to make it sort, just click on the column heading. So it is going to sort the work objects. Again, if you click on it again, it will be descending. Once ascending and other second time it is descending. Okay. And here it will only show the work objects which are in the new or open state. The status of the work object should be either new or open. If the work object is resolved, it will not display in the work list. Okay, it will not be in the work list. So the resolved work objects will be completely going out of the current operator and it will not be available in anybody's work object, in anybody's work list. So, and so yesterday we created one more operator like manager. In case if you log in as a manager portal, this is the developer portal, right? Where we are going to develop the application, where we are creating the application. Yeah, this is the manager portal, case manager portal. Okay, under the case manager portal, okay, if the person wants to create the work object, he can select here. Okay, in case if you log in as the developer portal, you can open the flow and you can run the flow and you can create the work object. But the case manager will not be have the developer portal. Okay, so if this person wants to create the work object, if you want to run the case, he can select new and again the case. If you have around 4 or 5 cases, everything will be listed out here. And you can select the case which you wanted to run, which you want to create the work object. And I said we have something called work list even for the manager. And where the manager can see his work list means he can see under his work. Okay, the tasks which are assigned to this particular manager. Okay, so and this is the dashboard. So under the dashboard also, okay, you have that something called HDFC manager work list. Okay, right now he don't have any work objects in his work list to further process, so he is not able to see anything. Okay, but generally if you have any work objects assigned to him, okay, he can see in the work list. So this is the work list. Okay, this is the work list. So now let me route any of the work object to this person. Customer details. Yesterday in the customer details flow, okay, we have routed to the different operator. So initially we have the screen flow, okay, which is the sub process, and after that we have the work object, second assignment. Okay, so here we are going to assign to the different person. So go to the assignment. Under the assignment properties, you can have something called operator. Okay, here we are going to select the operator name to whom you wanted to route it. Okay, as I said, in case if you want to route it to the manager approval, you can give the operator ID manager@hdfc.com. Okay, in case if you give prabhu@hdfc.com or any other operator ID, it will go to that particular operator for the approval. Okay, so save it. Now, if you run this work object, so first sub process will be run by the developer one. And later, the remaining work object processing can be done by the manager@hdfc.com. See, now it is going to create a new work object. Okay, with the ID 106. Okay, so this is the screen flow, right? Okay, policy details, vehicle incidents, four wheeler section like that. Okay, we have it in the second one. Okay. Now after that, okay, in general, the next assignment also should be displayed to the same person. But this time it is showing that the next step in this case has been routed appropriately. So it has been routed to the manager. So now if you log in as a manager and you can see that. Earlier in his work list, okay, it was blank, but now you got it 106. Okay, so when you select my work also, it will show you the work object which is assigned to the manager. So like that, we can route it to the different persons, different operators, and that operator can log in and he can do the processing. Okay, so right now who can work on 106 work object? Is it possible to work by the developer one, or is it possible to work by the Prabhu?
No.
Yeah, only the manager operator ID can open this work object and he can further process the work object. Okay, so only one operator is able to work. In case if this manager is on leave, okay, he went on vacation and he may be not available for next one week to 10 days. So in that case, how? So in that case, what we can do is, okay, instead of routing to the specific operator, okay, instead of routing to the specific operator, we can route it to the work basket. Okay, so we can route it to the work basket. So what is mean by work basket? I hope now everybody is clear about the work list. So work list means the list which contains the work objects for one specific operator, either only for manager, otherwise only for the developer one. So work list means it is specific to one particular operator who can work on that particular work objects. But whereas if multiple operators should be able to work on the work objects, then we need to create, first thing is work basket, and then the second thing is work group. Okay, second thing is work group. So let me have one small example. Like, okay, for example, right now how it is having, we have something called operator one. Okay, so operator one means like manager. Okay, so manager is an operator. Okay, if you wanted to process any of the work objects, where he can go? He can go to his work list. Okay, so in his work list, he'll be having the complete list of the work objects which are assigned to this person. Okay, Z-1, Z-2, Z-3, likewise. Okay, there is something called one work list available. The work list displays all the work objects which are related to the manager. Okay, now I said if this manager is available, then he can pick up the work object. Okay, he can pick up the work object and then he can further process it. Okay, work object one. Okay, work object two. And then work object three. Likewise, he can see the complete list of the work objects which are assigned to this particular operator. Okay, but if this operator goes on leaves, they are not able to work on any operator. So in that case, what I can do is, for example, okay, we have something called various operators. Okay, we have various operators like manager 2 at HDFC. Okay, and in the same way, so likewise, there are totally four managers available: manager 1, manager 2, 3, and 4. Okay, four people are there. So by default, every operator contains his own work list. Okay, right now, as manager contains his own work list, which contains three work objects, in the same way, manager 2 also will be having his own work list, 3 also, 4 also. Okay, but along with their own specific work list, okay, we can have one more thing. Okay, so as I said, it is a work list. So work list is specific to the particular operator. So it's a manager work list which contains his work objects. Okay, now in the same way, now we can have one more thing that is called work basket. Second. We can have something called work basket. Okay, so this work basket is also called work cube. Okay, whether you call it as a work basket, whether you call it as a work cube, both are same. Okay, so we have something called work basket. So now what I will do is, okay, in this work basket, okay, you can route it to the work basket. So you can move the work objects to the work baskets, okay, like w hyphen 22. Fine. Okay, so likewise you can create, okay, you can create various work objects into the work basket. Okay, now this work baskets will be assigned to this work basket will be assigned to work group. Okay, so work group means it's collection of operators. Okay, work group is a collection of the operators like manager 2, manager 3, manager 4. And later, this work group will be assigned to work basket. Okay. Now, this work object processing can be done by any of the operator under this work group. Okay, any of the operator under this work group. Okay, so we don't have the problem like work list. Why? Because here, if the manager is available, then only he can open the work object and he can either approve or reject it. In case if he goes on leave, and these will be on his work list until unless this guy comes back to the office and he selects the work object and then further processing. Okay, but whereas in the work group, okay, once if you move any of the work objects to the work group, what will happen is, okay, whoever part of this work group, either manager 2, manager 3, or manager 4. Okay, these people can open the work object and they can either approve or reject it. Okay, they can approve or reject it. So why? Because if one person goes on leave, even another person will be there. So they can see the work objects which are under this work basket. And then he can process it. So for this first, what we should have? We should have the work basket. And then we should have the work group, and then we need to assign the operators to the work group. So once if you assign the operators to the work group, then while creating the work object, so earlier we used to route it to the particular person. Okay, so we have routed to the manager at hdfc.com, or we have routed to the Prabhu at hdfc.com. Okay, but now not like that. We can route it to the work basket. Okay. So how we can apply this one? So let's go to the development portal. Okay, so in this, for the customer details flow, so once after creating the work object, okay, we have routed to the manager. Okay, we have given it should be route to operator, that is the manager at hdfc.com. Okay, now what we can give? we can give something called work queue. Okay, we can give something called work queue. And then we have to give the what we should refer here. What we should refer, either work basket or work queue, which clearly specified earlier operator. Now it is work queue. Work queue means it is a group of the work objects which contains, which can be stored in the work basket or work queue. Okay, like exceptional cases. Okay, as I said, if the insurance amount is more than 1 crore, then we need the manager approval. So again, that also, instead of routing to the specific manager, I would like to place it to the may exceptional cases work basket. Okay, so do we have this exceptional cases work basket? No, we have something called broken process, chicken candidates, all these things available, but we don't have anything like a specific exceptional cases work basket. Okay, and so in case if you want to create any of the work basket, okay, either we can do the save as, okay, either we can do the save as, otherwise we can create a new one. Okay, for example, let me open this This is not in our application, right? All applications. Otherwise, let's take our HDFC. Okay, so here we have under the organization we'll be having the work queue category. If you select this also, you can see all the complete list of the work queues which are available. Okay, so we have something called HDFC Insurance Implementation Managers. Okay, so this also you can do the save as, otherwise you can use the same thing. And mainly here, when you are creating new work group, new work basket and new work queue, so there is a naming convention which you have to follow. Okay, you have to follow the naming convention. Always the prefix of the work queue should be your application name. Okay, here our application name is HDFC Insurance Implementation. Okay, so right now when we create our application, by default it has created one work queue, that is manager's work queue. Okay, so likewise for each and every application you will be having some predefined work queues for users, managers, authors. Even for our implementation also, managers, authors, administrator. Okay, here also administrator, here also users. Likewise, 4 will be created by default, 4. Okay, SBI vehicles for some other application, users, managers, authors and administrators. Okay, so likewise by default you will be having 4 work queues. Either you can reuse of them, otherwise you can create your own work queue. Okay, so this is just a short description, anything you can view. Okay, exceptional cases, managers. And here I said, the initial thing should be your application name. And then here, this can be whatever you want. Okay, like exceptional cases, managers. Okay, create and open. Okay, so this is the work queue which I have created right now. And this work queue, okay, you can have something called standard and robotic. If it is a robotic application, then you can have the robotic address standard. And after that, your application name, organization name, division name, unit name. Okay, organization, division, and unit. And then work group. Okay, here the work group is like default at HDFC Insurance. So what is this work group? I told you. So once if you create the work group, you can make the people as part of this work group. Okay, and then this work group we are assigning to the work basket. So while creating the work basket, that is work queue, so we are going to refer the work group name. For this work queue, we are going to refer the work group name. Okay, so default at HDFC Insurance. Okay, yeah, let it be this work group. And even if you open this work group, okay, you can see that, okay, you can see that the administrator, the manager name is administrator@pega.com, and it is part of the default work queue. Okay, what is the default work queue? Default at HDFC Insurance. Okay, default at HDFC Insurance. And as I said, even if you want, you can create your own work group as well. Okay, let's do save as of this. My team or any other description. Okay. Here also, exceptional cases. Exceptional cases at HDFC Insurance. Okay, create and open. Save it. Okay, so now we created one work group. Okay, and then we created one work queue. Okay, so here what is the work group name which we created? Exceptional cases. HDFC Insurance. So in the work queue, we refer the work group which we have created. Even under the work group also, we need to select the work queue which we have created. So what is the work queue which we created? HDFC Insurance implementation. Exceptional managers. Ours is what? Implementation. Okay, exceptional case managers. Like this. Okay, so now in the work group we have to select the work queue. Okay, in the work queue we have to select the work group. Okay, now we have ready of work queue as well as work group. Next thing is what? We need to have the operators as part of this work group. Okay, so as part of this work group, we close the remaining thing. So we have to make the operators as part of this work group. So just to create any operator. How can we create the operator? Just to save as this. Okay. So in general, we used to give these things, but along with that, now you can have something called under the profile. Along with the profile, you'll be having something called work. So under this work, along with the organization, division, and unit, you have something called work group. So here you can specify that, okay, this operator belongs to which work group. Okay, so what is our work group? Exceptional cases at HDFC insurance. And then save it. Okay, now Narendra is part of the exceptional cases at HDFC insurance. Okay, this is the work group, he is part of it. Now here, earlier we used to give the operator ID for, at the assignment level to whom you wanted to route it. So now instead of the operator, we can select work queue. So what is the work queue? HDFC insurance implementation : exceptional case managers, and then save it. Then save it. Okay. So second. Now once if you create the work object, but Narendra we created as a developer or what exactly? Let me see that. So it's routed. The next step in this case has been routed appropriately. So it's gone to the work queue. Okay. So where we can see the work queues? Yeah. He is also a developer operator ID. Okay. He is also a developer operator ID. Okay, but before going to that developer operator ID work group, I will show you as a end user portal, that is like manager. See, generally for the manager, either he is able to see in his work list, but as I said that, okay, if you have something called work queue, so where exactly you can see the work queue means, okay, here you can see the work queues. Okay, here you can see the work queues. So exceptional case managers Z-107. So as it's been moved to exceptional case managers work queue, okay, and even this manager is also having the access to this work queue, he can also select this and he can also process this. Okay, now who all are can process this one? All the operators who belongs to this work group. Okay, all the operators who belongs to this work group can open this. So in the end user portal, in the dashboard, okay, you can have the complete list of the work queues, that is like work basket. Okay, so he can select the work basket. Okay, he can select the work basket, and in the work basket he can see the list of the work objects under this work queue, and then he can process it. Okay, and then he can process it. So this is the difference between work list and work queue. So work list means which is specific to the particular operator, okay, which is Z-106, and work queue means it's a part of the multiple operators. Okay, who all are having the access to this work queue can open and can process it. Okay, so let me see whether two people is having the access to this or not. I want to see the operators Narendra operator ID, and I want to see the manager operator ID also. So where exactly we can see the manager operator ID? All the operators are under the category of manager@hdfc.com. Okay. His access group is what? Managers. But whereas this Narendra access group is what? Administrator. So as he is the administrator, he can log in as a developer portal. But once if you log in as a manager@hdfc.com, okay, you will be seeing the case manager portal. Okay, you'll be seeing the case manager portal. In case if Narendra also should log in as a case manager means, okay, we can refer that access group. We can make that access group as a default one. Okay, this radio button says the default access group which it should be logged in. Select. Okay, now log off. This time Narendra also is getting the end user portal, but earlier it was a developer portal. Okay, now in his work list nothing is there. Why it is not showing the exceptional one? Did we assign that work group to the Narendra also? I told you, right? Okay, whoever part of that work group, so we have to that work group under for this particular operator. So did we give that one? So where we can give that work group? It's not a developer one. For Narendra, we would like to apply that. So for Narendra, go to work. Okay, exceptional cases. Yeah, it's fine, right?
Hello.
Yeah. Satish?
Sir, after running. Hello.
Yeah, Satish.
Sir, Narendra.
Narendra, yeah, tell me.
Sir, we changed Narendra to manager just now, sir.
Yeah, correct. But that Narendra
is not showing anywhere.
We changed Narendra. Okay, but that is just a portal. Okay, that is just a access group. Okay, HDFC managers. Okay, instance implementation : managers. This is the access group. Okay, and for this operator ID, we have given this work group. Right. So this work group contains the work basket. Okay. This is the work queue. So this has to be displayed to the user. Okay, now when you log in as a manager@hdfc.com, okay, how you are able to see the work queue? In the same way, you should be, even the Narendra also should be able to see that work group. Default at HDFC insurance. Okay, it's there. Default at HDFC insurance. Exceptional cases at HDFC insurance. One second. Work queue, why when we log in as a manager, it was showing exceptional cases at HDFC insurance. But here it is showing that there are no work objects in that. Did we process or what exactly happened? So now this manager is able to see exceptional cases manager's work queue, and this contains this work object. Okay, so in the same way, now if the Narendra logs in, even he should be able to see this exceptional cases manager's work queue. Okay, why? Because that Narendra also assigned this work queue for him. See, he is able to see only manager's work queue. Okay, but he is not able to see that. Why? What could be the reason? If anybody is part of that work group, they all should be able to see those work queues. So now we need to see the difference between the manager and the Narendra. So the manager operator ID and the Narendra operator ID. So this is the Narendra operator ID. And then this is the manager operator ID. So he is part of the manager's group, manager's access group. Okay, he is part of the manager's access group. Okay, and this operator, now Narendra contains exceptional cases at hdfc.com, HDFC insurance. Okay, so when he is part of this, you should be able to see that. This is the work group. And this is the work group for him. Exceptional cases. Yeah, this is also correct. Defaulted. Case if you give let me just try with this. Narendra. No, he is getting. But actually, you should get when you refer this directly. Okay, when Narendra should get it directly when he is part of this exceptional cases managers. This is part of the portal under the access group. So this guy is referring to PY case manager 7. Okay. And even the manager at HDFC also will be referring to the same portal. Yeah. Case manager, okay. Available role. So everything is same. Both are referring to the same access group. In both are referring to the same access group. The only difference Narendra contains is the other access groups. Okay. So now Narendra refers and the manager also refers the same access group. Okay. So this is the access group. Under the access group, we can only select that portal, okay, and then available roles. Work pools. So operator. So these three people belongs to this manager access group. Okay. Default to destination rule set. Okay, 1 second. Yeah, now we got it. So now Narendra also getting the same exceptional case managers. So these are the default work queues everybody will be getting. Okay, and along with that, you'll be getting the exceptional case manager as well. Okay, so now even the Narendra one also can process this case. Otherwise, manager at HDFC also can process this case. Why? Because both are referring to the same work queue, and as both the people are part of this work queue, so anybody part of this work queue can open the cases and then they can further process the work object. So he can also can open this and he can further process the work object like this. So if one person is goes on leave, the second person can be processing the work object. This is called work list and again work basket. So work list means specific to one particular operator. Work basket means group of people can access the work objects. Okay. So these things we can apply under the flow assignment level. Okay. So if it is the standard flow, he can give it at the assignment level. If it is a screen flow, where exactly we can give? Anybody who attended yesterday? So here at each and every assignment level, we can route it to the different people. But whereas if it is a screen flow, where exactly we can view? This is a screen flow, right? So here also, can we give it on the assignment level? See, in the assignment properties, we only have the flow action. We are not able to give the route. So in the screen flow, we can give it at the start shape. Okay, under the start shape, if you come down here, you can see the route. Okay, so what is the router? To work list or to work basket, something like that. So to the work basket. So to which work basket again you wanted to route it, so that you can select it here. Okay. So like that means whenever the work object is created, immediately it will go to the particular work basket if you give it at the start shape. Okay, not in the middle of the flow. Immediately, right away, whenever the work object created, it will go to that particular work basket. Okay, so this is the thing. And the next thing is like, okay, we need to work on something like a reports. Okay, so generally in the previous classes also, we just created a report definition at the high level, right? So I hope, I am not sure how many of you remember, once we created the states and the cities, so to populate the data from the cities and states, we have created our report definition. Okay, so we created the report definitions. And so these are the data types which we created earlier for cities and states and again customers or something like that. Okay, which stores the particular cities. Okay, these are the cities which we created earlier. Okay, now here to read the data from this particular data type. Okay, to read these particular cities, okay, we implemented various ways. So what are the things we implemented? Through activity also we have retrieved by using the OBJ browse, and after that activity we called from the data page. Okay, we called from the data page, and in the same way, okay, we used to create the report definition as well. Okay, Indian cities. So these are the data types which we used for populating the data onto the drop downs. Okay, so now along with these data types, okay, if you open this data type, okay, so for this list, okay, we referred the data table editor report. So this data table editor report was the report definition, okay, which contains, so this is the report definition, okay, which is going to read the particular columns, particular values from the data type, and it was displaying. Okay, now even these data types, okay, in case if you want to retrieve the data, we can use the report definition from multiple tables as well. Okay, so here Indian cities, one data type. Indian states, one data type. Okay, Indian cities and Indian states, likewise we have two data types. Okay, so once if you run this, we are able to see the particular states which are only available in this records. Okay, these states we used to see by running the data page, right? These three are the default Pega data pages created. Okay, this is the savable. Okay, and along with that, this is for retrieving the all states. Okay, and this is for retrieving the particular state. Okay, run these actions, run. So this lists all the records from this data page. Okay. So Andhra Pradesh, state ID, country ID, all these things like this. So only state information it contains, the record one. Okay. And then if you see the record two, Arunachal Pradesh. Okay. So likewise, we used the data pages, okay, through this data page. So this data page internally referring to what? Report definition. Okay, so this report definition refers what? The columns which you wanted to see to the user, state ID, country ID, state name, all these things. Okay, so in this Indian states, we also created retrieve states. This is created by us, we created for our own purpose. This functionality also same as like the one which Pega has created. This is also for written in the particular states. Okay, so here we are retrieving only for one data type. Okay, only states which are available in this data type. And if you run this Indian cities, it will only return the particular cities from this. But in case if you want to have the records from both the data types, okay, if you want to have the record from both the data types, that means if I select, okay, state as Telangana, and I want to see all the cities are part of that particular Telangana or Andhra Pradesh or Arunachal Pradesh, like that. So then what we can do is we can do the join between these two data types. Okay, so the joins, how we can do in the report definition, okay, we will be covering in the next class. So anybody has any queries regarding the work list or work baskets and how to route it and how to see the work objects from the work queue? Narendra?
No, sir.
Okay. Then yeah, if you are fine, yeah, let's close it today and we'll see you tomorrow. Okay.
Okay.